Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the Minister of Defence, Honourable Ms. Thandi Modise, and her entourage. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Chief of the South African Army, Lieutenant General Lawrence Kulegani Mbatha, we bid you a powerful welcome to the Distinguished Visitors Day, where Exercise Vukuhlome will showcase the SA Army's capabilities and firepower in the strength of a division. My name is Lieutenant Zebula, but for the purpose of this exercise, you can call me Sunshine. With me, I have Lieutenant Zakia Tinambo, and you can call her Zaza for the duration of this exercise. Good morning, Zaza.
Good morning, Sunshine. The land of diesel and dust, where when the boot hits the ground, training begins. When the steel helmet lands on the head and the battle jacket is on a soldier's back, the tire tracks of rattles. Infantry combat vehicles mark the road and the gunpowder fills the air. That's when it clicks. This is Luwatla Combat Training Center, the third largest training center in the Southern Hemisphere. And here is where training as we fight begins. We are the Pride of Lions. A blasting rise to you, ladies and gentlemen, and Sunshine. As the Pride of Lions, we have grown so much within the last 3 years since the Chief of the Army's vision for the Joint Course Exercise, formerly known as Exercise Ugutula, to be restored to its rightful glory of offering real-time practice experience to students on Junior Command and Staff Course, Integrated Sub-Unit Commander's Course, and ops duties. In 2020, after continuous threat assessments in the country, this exercise was done on a battalion level, which is comprised of three companies. Then in 2021, it elevated to a brigade level consisting of three battalions. The vision of the Chief of the South African Army in 2020 to create a modern brigade that is based in Luwatla Combat Training Center, the home of patriots, was based on a foresight of creating an army where a fully fledged combat ready landward force is accessible in the event of any threat to the country and its sovereignty, both in terms of the region and the continent. The July unrest affirmed the vision of the Chief of the South African Army as being beneficial for the safety of the country and ultimately bringing hope to its people. When the order was given to deploy an army in position to assist the SAPS. has been the cream of the crop. A first of this
magnitude. Gentlemen, a very good morning to each and every one of you. If you see smoke on the ground indicating front line of own troops, that symbolizes the autonomous air interdiction that we are about to conduct, led by the South African Air Force. They will be doing with two hawks coming in from the south. Before they do that, we're going to fire the crater from the South African engineers. With me is Captain Kweso, who's going to count it down. Captain.
Thank you, Colonel. We are going to fire just now. Firing point, just give us a countdown.
Positive for continuity. Continue to confirm.
Fire.
Zero. Three. Two.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you see that crater, that's 500 kilograms of TNT going up inbound from the south. Two Hawks, four Mach 81 bombs that will be dropped down on a target in front of you. The smoke on the ground indicating the front line of own troops for safety purposes, and the Hawks are rolling in inbound.
Gushi, I got two visual.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bombs have been released. Very shortly, they will be on the ground. These aircraft took off, ladies and gentlemen, this morning from Air Force Base Overberg in the Western Cape. We would have wanted them to deliver these bombs a little bit later. Unfortunately, they do not have much holding time as they need to be flying back. Please understand, ladies and gentlemen, this is simulated as autonomous air interdiction in the deep. Ideally, you would not be even seeing where these bombs have landed. The two Hawks will have delivered two each of Mach 81 aircraft bombs, and they are going to be setting up to do a run with 30 millimeter guns, after which they will then clear the range. Ladies and gentlemen, we have started the program to just clear the aircraft part that we had running on a time program. We will go back to the program and rerun it as was planned for you. I confirm the Hawks, they are currently pre-positioning themselves. They will be doing their run-in once again from the south. They will do the bombing of the area with the 30 millimeter guns, and from there they will continue. I confirm, ladies and gentlemen, that the situation that we are dealing with is in line with the training that the South African Army has been doing, which is multifaceted. These are typically some activities that you will see in the deep, while in the close and in the rear areas, a number of reactions will ideally take place that are in reaction or are simultaneous with the actions that we are doing. The Hawks have pre-positioned themselves to the south. They will be running in from the south, in other words, from your right to left. And they will then do their final interdiction by means of 30 millimeter guns, after which they will then clear the range. Observe as they have already pitched a fend and guns have been let loose. Ladies and gentlemen, the bombs were 100% on a target. The Hawks are pre-positioning again. They will do a quick fly past, and this time around they will be doing it from north to south as they clear the range in the south to return back to base. They are currently pre-positioning themselves. They have been cleared for their fly past. Ladies and gentlemen, as we await their return for the fly past, please keep your eye also in the close battle area, in the home ground, which is where we are. We have had quite a number of situations that we have been dealing with. While we have dealt with the belligerents by means of this autonomous air interdiction that we have just seen, a number of people have been unhappy with service delivery. And here in the close, we also have got a number of situations that requires some of the elements within the state machinery to deal with. You will see that in front of you, in the village that we have, as the Hawks are coming in for their final fly past from left to right, they are now greeting us, ladies and gentlemen, as they clear the range back to Air Force Base Overberg down in the Western Cape. Back, ladies and gentlemen, to the scenario at hand. We have had quite a number of service delivery protests based on the requirement by our people to receive a certain services, and this has resulted in a mass act of civil disobedience in the form of an unauthorized and unlawful demonstration that you see taking place in front of you. It is important to note, ladies and gentlemen, that normally under these circumstances, the presence of law enforcement tends to irritate demonstrators, and this many a times results in a civil disobedience getting out of hand. In the regard of the current situation at hand, the police have been called upon to try and bring calmness and peace to this situation, where we want the police to deal with potential opportunists that might be hiding amongst the crowd in order to exploit the situation for their own nefarious purposes. It is also important to note, ladies and gentlemen, under these circumstances, that potential instigators tends to occur where they would like to instigate the crowd to also achieve various of their nefarious needs. The police have now arrived, ladies and gentlemen, and they will try to contain the situation to make sure that they bring it under control and bring about as quickly as possible peace and order to this area. These police that you see here in front, ladies and gentlemen, are simulated by our own military police due to the unavailability of our South African Police Service members. The military police, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the divisions within the South African National Defence Force that is equipped with the same capabilities and profession that the South African Police Service has. They are also empowered with the necessary skills and knowledge to deal with crowd situations such as you can see in front of you, however limited their capability is. In a situation like this, ladies and gentlemen, as you will observe, that the situation requires that the police needs to have control over this. However, if the escalation takes place, as we observe now, that the escalation might take place, We want to have their eyes and ears and see what is happening in order to make decisions. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got our own embedded journalist as well as our own eyes in the skies that is giving us information about what is taking place there. And on the line now, I have got one of our journalists that is on the ground. It is Sunshine. Sunshine, are you online?
I confirm, sir, I am on the ground. I am on the ground.
Can you please tell us what is the situation now on the ground and what can we expect after the arrival of the police there?
Thank you. Reporting live at King Monada informal settlement. I hope the viewers can see the situation here at King Monada is very, very bad at the moment. Residents just protesting, taking to the streets, complaining that the government has indeed ignored all of their efforts. They are even saying that they are the forgotten informal settlement. Currently, the police are trying to control the crowd, but the people are pushing the police. It is getting violent. As the viewers can see, there is fire. They are burning tires. Roads are closed. It is really, really bad.
Okay, thank you, Sunshine, for that. We have heard now there has been rumors that the crowd has is overpowering the police, and there is a possibility of the South African National Defense Force being called in. Have you been able to confirm these rumors?
I would like to confirm to all the viewers that it is indeed true that the police are trying their best, but it is really, really bad with the crowd overpowering the police. The crowd also, they are armed, they are throwing bricks at the police, they've got plugs on. It is really, really getting out of hand. Even myself with the crew, we are just trying to be safe at the moment. It's really, really bad. And the South African National Defense Force has been called, I can confirm, to come and try and make the situation better.
Thank you very much, Sunshine, for that information. Ladies and gentlemen, on our screens now, we have already observed the movement of the soldiers as they are approaching King Monada informal settlement, and we wait to see how the circumstances will develop there as time goes on. Sunshine, please keep safe where you are, but try to get us as much information as possible and brief us as to what is going on there.
All right, as the viewers can see that the South African National Defense Force has indeed been called to come to the ground to try and make the situation better. Viewers can see the vehicles have now arrived. The citizens still overpowering the police and the police moving back to allow the South African National Defense Force to take position and to assist. As the viewers can see, they are now disembarking their vehicles to try and assist the police. The citizens are still very much violent towards the police. The situation is still getting worse. Also, we're worried about the safety of women and children. It's just chaotic here at King Monada informal settlement at the moment. But the South African National Defense Force is on the ground to try and mitigate the situation.
Thank you very much, Sunshine. Ladies and gentlemen, there. Members that you have seen arriving at the scene at King Monada informal settlement are members of the South African Army. They are coming in from the Light Modern Brigade, one of the new innovations of the South African Army in terms of modernizing its force. We have just been informed, ladies and gentlemen, that additional members of the National Defense Force will be arriving to reinforce the members already on the ground. These members will be confirmed as soon as they have reached their position. I will write to request Sanjan to please confirm if indeed the members are indeed coming and arriving.
All right, I hope the viewers can see. The South African National Defense Force is on the ground. They are doing crowd control. They are obviously augmenting the South African Police Service in trying to make the situation better at King Monada informal settlement. But I can also attest that the South African National Defense Force is not violent towards the residents of King Monada informal settlement. They are just doing crowd control. And also, I am seeing a difference in the situation.
situation in a sense that the people are starting to move back. They are starting to listen. There's a really a situation change at the moment. Some of them just lifting up their plugs, telling the SANDF that they're not happy with the government in terms of service delivery. They've been neglected in terms of basic healthcare needs, as well as housing, amongst other complaints that they have. But like I said, I just see a sense of respect as well in terms of the involvement from the South African National Defence Force. You know, just they're speaking to the people well. The violence has sort of subsided. The people are just at the moment just protesting and singing, but they are no longer pushing the police. And as the viewers can see, the police are standing behind the South African National Defence Force. I would say at the moment the situation is somehow controlled.
Thank you very much, Sunshine. Ladies and gentlemen, I can confirm now additional information received that the members of the South African National Defence Force that have been deployed to King Munada are members of the South African Army Special Infantry Capability. They are based out in Potchefstroom in the Northwest Province. This is part of the resuscitated capability that is aimed at ensuring that the South African Army has got a specialized capability to protect and do activities of military activities in their rare areas. These members are trained, ladies and gentlemen, to utilize the Mamba vehicles, motorbikes, dogs, horses, and you will see that all these capabilities have now been deployed here, the purpose of which is to deal with situation of crowd control, riotous situation, as well as various rural and urban operations that they are able to also do. These members, ladies and gentlemen, are highly trained in these specialized operations. It is for that reason that they have been identified to be the one to provide support to the South African police. The vehicles that you see approaching now from the south are elements that are members of the light infantry capability. There is the CASPAs that have also been resuscitated in the initiative of the Chief of the Army out in Bloemfontein. And you can see, ladies and gentlemen, where everybody has thought that this is a capability that has died down, we have restored it back into service, and you will see them in action now. You will see that in front of you, ladies and gentlemen, around the unruly crowd, an inner cordon in the form of motorcycles has been established, and outside the outer cordon has been established by means of the Mambas. The CASPAs are going to form out an outer perimeter patrol where they are going to make sure that no interference can be brought to this contained situation from outside, while the members on the inside are observing and making sure that the instigators to this situation that is unlawful have been identified and that further lawful actions will be taken against them after this. Please take note, ladies and gentlemen, that an operation of this nature is controlled from a joint operational center that has been established just to the north of where you are seated, the grandstand. The JOG is then in charge and it is manned by members of both the South African Police Service as well as the National Defence Force. These members are the ones responsible to make the final decision with regards to how the situation in front is contained and dealt with. There has been a report, ladies and gentlemen, of various injuries that has been sustained by both members of the police and members of the South African Special Infantry Capability. To that end, ladies and gentlemen, the medical capability has been activated to come and do medical evacuation from the area back to a level 2 medical facility that has been established behind the JOG, that is the area right behind you. Once the medical facility, the medical phases have arrived, these are members, ladies and gentlemen, from the South African Medical Health Capability. This divisional exercise have been supported by a brigade that has come from the medical health services, and it is these members that will now be conducting the casualty evacuation that you will see in front. They will arrive, they will get to the injured personnel,
They will first start the stabilization activities to make sure that the patients have been stabilized, and then from there they will then evacuate them to the level 2 facility. Important to note, ladies and gentlemen, is that amongst the phases that you see in front, one of them is actually manned by veterinary or vets that are also responsible for the health of the animals that you see out here, where both the horses as well as the dogs' health and welfare is being taken care of. These members are part of the medical fraternity that you see deployed in front, who will be doing the medical evacuation. The situation has been confirmed to be contained, ladies and gentlemen. The eye in the sky from our intelligence fraternity have confirmed that an instigator has been identified. The process of profiling the instigator is currently in process, and a number of people, we are waiting to get a confirmation. However, it is confirmed that a number of people have been taken into custody so far. I'm going to ask a verification confirmation from our journalist on the ground, Sunshine. Sunshine, are you with me?
I'd like to confirm that I am still with you. I'm still with you on the ground. All right, the situation here at King Munada informal settlement, the South African National Defense Force has brought in some medical personnel in order to assist the members that are injured. There's also been some arrests in terms of the members who are armed and who have been violent towards law enforcement. Some law enforcement members, I can confirm that they have been injured, unfortunately, as this protest has become violent, but the medical personnel are currently attending to those members that are injured on the ground. The situation is quite stable at the moment. We're just watching the South African National Defense Force moving in, as well as doing some medical assistance on the ground. And the citizens have become less violent at the moment, but the protests are still happening in some parts of King Munada informal settlement.
Thank you very much, Sunshine. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got that confirmation that the 12 members that had been injured have all been stabilized, and they have been loaded on various ambulances and will be taken up to a level 2 facility. Also reported, ladies and gentlemen, is that there have been some injuries to the canine capability, the dogs. There is also some of them that will be taken for further attention by medical professionals at a level 2 facility to the rear. The situation is reported to be contained, ladies and gentlemen, and we have now received a report that there is some interference that is coming out from coming in from outside King Munada settlement. The special forces have been dispatched to intercept this vehicle. They have got on the Augusta 109 snipers from special forces, as well as various other members of special forces on vehicles, on Hornet vehicles. The vehicle has been successfully intercepted, and we await to receive additional information in terms of what is happening there. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the intelligence fraternity have informed us that these members are directly linked to the unrest that we have seen taking place in King Munada informal settlement. They were waiting for our forces to withdraw in order for them to come in and bring additional mayhem to this area. It is confirmed that the bus that has been intercepted, ladies and gentlemen, has been found to be fully laden with explosive, and currently members of the special forces are busy trying to determine what kind of the bombs that has been. In the meantime, the members, the occupants of this bus, have been arrested. The MPs were called in to take them into custody, and the special forces have made a decision to escort this bomb-laden vehicle out of the settlement to a safe area where they will then take further action to dispose of and destroy the bombs that are inside of this vehicle. Escorted by the snipers that are on board the Augusta 109, as well as the Hornets, both in front and behind this confiscated vehicle. They will be escorted out of the settlement to a safe area where members of the South African Special Forces will then dispose of that bomb by means of destroying it. Sunshine, can you confirm what is the latest on the ground with regards to the withdrawal of both members of the South African Police and the South African National Defence Force?
All right, I am still here on the ground. The situation has just turned from the time I reported that it was stable, a suspicious vehicle of members reported to have been taking advantage of the situation here at King Munada Informal Settlement, were apprehended by the South African Special Forces. It became something. But at the moment, I can confirm to the viewers that the situation once more is stable again. Thank you to the South African Special Forces that came in. And now the forces are about to withdraw. There is peace restored at King Munada Informal Settlement. The South African National Defence Force members are now withdrawing. They are taking their dogs as well as their members out of the vicinity of King Munada Informal Settlement. I'll just also remind viewers that what happened here at King Munada Informal Settlement, where the South African National Defence Force was called in, is not the first time that we are seeing the South African National Defence Force doing that, as we have seen with other riots that happened in the country, with the Operation Notlela, where the South African National Defence Force took to the streets during COVID-19 unrest to assist the police once more.
Thank you very much, Sunshine. Ladies and gentlemen, we had the benefit of our eyes in the skies as well as eyes on the floor in order to give us the intelligence of what is going on here. As you can see them exfiltrated. To talk about the deployment of our intelligence elements, I have got with us in the studio Major Poison, who's going to talk to us about what are the techniques that were used and how the intelligence picture was built by his members. Major Poison, are you with us? Sunshine, confirm, is Major Poison with you in that studio?
I confirm he is not in my position.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as we await the arrival of Major Poison to the studio, I can confirm that it will not be possible for any of the members of the military to execute any of the tactical actions that they execute without the support of the eyes in the sky and the eyes on the ground, the ears in the sky and the ears on the ground. These are the members, ladies and gentlemen, that get deployed long before any of our activities take place, and they are able to then pick up what is happening on the ground, feed the information and intelligence to the commander in order for him to make plans. Major Poison, I believe, has joined us now. Major Johnson, are you with us? Major Poison.
Thank you very much, Colonel. I am Major Poison from 1 Tactical Intelligence Regiment in Potchefstroom. We are the eyes and the ears of the SA Army. The battlefield surveillance sources deployed are from one tactical intelligence regiment. They have been deployed for 72 hours already. These elements have been collecting information on opposing forces as well as their activities. They are making use of specialist systems like the Battlefield Surveillance Systems, BSS, with an effective range of up to 16 kilometers. Advanced Surveillance Products, ASP, with a range of up to plus minus 35 kilometers. The teams that are very special because they can infiltrate by foot for up to plus minus 15 kilometers with a big bag which is weighing plus minus 65 kilograms. And then they can be self-sustained for a period of over 7 days. So we are indeed the eyes and the ears of the SA Army, and then we do this by giving early warning and also deploying detection systems. Thank you very much, Colonel.
Thank you very much, Major Boyson. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the how we operate. And I want to thank Major Boyson for the job well done for making sure that our forces have got the eyes and ears on the ground. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to, you see the smoke that is in front of you. This is for the airborne activities that are going to take place with me now. I am joined by Colonel Dixon, who will be conducting this part of the operation for us, and he is ready to talk to us about what they have prepared. Colonel Dixon.
Thank you, Victor. Colonel Dixon here. As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, moving in from the north, there are three helicopters. First aircraft is the Augusta. It is commanded by Major Malloy and Staff Engelbrecht. The Oryx helicopter, the large one to the south, is commanded by Lieutenant Colonel Tarantal and Captain Grossman. Roy Falk has taken up overwatch position for the drop-off of the airborne force. Roy Falk pilot is Lieutenant Colonel Ramoy Poise and Captain Mashlangu. They are from 16th Squadron. They are now taking up a position for overwatch over the position, and now the Oryx helicopter will move in to drop the airborne assault force on the yellow smoke. Oryx running in. On board 12 members from 6i Infantry Battalion. Members from 6i is the Air Assault Unit from the Eastern Cape. They will now take up all-round position to allow the Assault Force Commander to bring in heavy equipment. Vacate to the north to collect the heavy freight that will be deployed. Roy Falk is still in overwatch. Augusta is now moving in from the north. On board of the Augusta is the ground commander of the force. He will now be relocating to the ground to take command of the forces on the ground. Augusta is the onboard command post, and the pilot of the aircraft is the air mission commander that will control all the helicopters in the air. Roy Falk is still busy with overwatch. Augusta is taking off. With helicopter operations, speed is of the essence. Time spent on the ground with helicopters be to reduce to the minimum. Assault Force Commander will now reposition his soldiers to take up all-round defense position for the arrival of the heavy equipment. The heavy equipment, as we speak, is currently being loaded at the back. They will be cargo slinged in, and the load will comprise out of one Gecko rapid deployment logistical vehicle. Right, Augusta is coming in for landing again. There was a bit of a snag, dropping off the ground commander. Right, Augusta still on the ground. Oryx are busy now hooking up the heavy freight. Why is the Augusta on the ground? Right, we are now waiting the Oryx. Oryx is inbound from the south, that is to your right. Roy Falk is still protecting the force. Ground, the air mission commander is still controlling all air movement. Right, Oryx inbound, 2 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, to your front is now the Oryx coming in to drop off the heavy load of the airborne force. The slung load underneath the Oryx helicopter is the Gecko. That is the rapid deployment logistical vehicle used by the airborne to move heavy equipment from the dropping or landing zones to the area of deployment. The Oryx can sling about 2.5 tons. Only disadvantage is that it flies at a slower speed, about 75 knots. Right, Gecko on the ground. And the Oryx will now release the load. Roy Falk is still flying overwatch. Right, Oryx have done his job. And they are now bugging out. The assault force will now form up to continue with their mission. Right, that concludes the helicopter part of this exercise. Just to demonstrate a few of the techniques that the airborne can use to rapidly deploy and maneuver forces across the battlefield. They will also now form up for a quick fly pass. Then, ladies and gentlemen, currently inbound, clear from the hold. We have got 2 aircraft running in to do the Pathfinder deployment. That will comprise out of an Kaza and a Caravan. Right, helicopters are forming up to our west for a quick fly pass and a final photo session of the capabilities of the South African Air Force. Right, there goes the members now of 6 South African Infantry Battalion, air assault soldiers for the South African Defence Force. Right, we are waiting now for the fly pass and then for the parachute demonstration.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the members of the Airborne Fraternity conducting heliborne operations. And shortly, we will be observing then the parachute assault that is going to take place. Coming in from the south, ladies and gentlemen, these are the people that will go in into the deep area. They will be inserted vertically by means of air and in this case the parachute. The purpose of this is for them to be able to deploy on the ground and gather the information, mark LZ. But Colonel Dixon will continue to explain in detail what the purpose of this deployment is as they are inbound. William, please take us through.
Thank you, Victor. Right, ladies and gentlemen, the Khaza and the caravan has been cleared in. They're about 1.5 minutes out. They will fly in from the south. If you want to see the paradrop, you will have to come out from underneath your cover so you can observe. The aircraft will fly in from the south. We've got two aircraft. One is the Khaza 212 from 44 Squadron. The aircraft is commanded by Lieutenant Colonel Green, co-pilot Major Ferreira, and Sergeant Tanda as the flight engineer. We also got a caravan running in. Right, to your left, fly pass helicopter formation. Right, give them a wave. Right, thank you for the helicopters. We are now waiting, as I've said, for the freefall drop. The second aircraft is the Caravan 208, Cessna 208, commanded by Lieutenant Ferreira. And yes, he's the wife of Major Ferreira, flying in the Khaza. And then Captain Sutra, codenamed Sutra, which is a co-pilot. On board of these two aircraft, we have got two Pathfinder teams, a senior and a junior one. The senior group will jump from the Khaza, a simulated HAPO, that means high altitude, high operations type of jump, where the jumper is above 18,000 feet above ground, and they of course will use oxygen, in this case simulated. Second aircraft, the caravan, will drop six static line, advanced static line paratroopers. All right, if you see now above us, caravan and Khaza flying, crossing over from south to north. Okay, Khaza, exit, exit, exit. Free fallers are now falling, accelerating to 220 kilometers per hour before they will open up their parachutes at around about 3,500 feet above ground. Khaza flying in will drop advanced static line. Right, there goes the first advanced static line jumper from the Khaza. Right, you can see to your left is the free fallers. All their parachutes are now open. They include six jumpers, seven jumpers from 44 Parachute Regiment and the tandem master, Captain Bajana. The static line jumpers is further to the east. They are the less experienced Pathfinders. This is their first demonstration ever. So they are new to the business. They are still under training, but we thought it good to bring them over to demonstrate the level of their training. The jumpers will now form up at the opening height and they will start stacking into a line and then they will follow in and land to your position where the smoke is. The red smoke is for the senior HAPO jumpers and the yellow smoke further down onto the fire break is for the advanced static liners. The parachute that they are using are locally manufactured TA-300 parachutes. The 300 stands for 300 square meters for the parachute itself, big enough to carry a jumper with his prime mission equipment. They are currently holding upwind, and when they come near to the ground, they will fly on a down leg, turn around, and land into the wind. The square canopy or the ram air type parachute allows the jumper to land at higher wind conditions. That means it's ideally suited for the infiltration of specialists. So these techniques are primarily used by the South African Special Forces as well as the South African Pathfinders to infiltrate to execute their mission. And this mission is always in the deep. Paratroopers are always surrounded. the first jumper coming in. You can see he's got his PEC, personal equipment container, strapped to his legs. He will lower it at some stage onto his feet, and he'll kick it off his feet prior to landing to prevent him from landing on his equipment. Right, wind conditions is very important. The wind this morning changed, so anything can happen. First jumper coming in, you can see on his legs is the PEC, personal equipment container. The ram air parachute can be steered, turned, and prior to landing, he will flare to soften the landing. Beautiful. It takes years of training to reach this level of proficiency, because many things can go wrong from exit to landing, and the jumper must be prepared for anything. During the rehearsal jumps, we had two cutaways. We are very fortunate today that we had no cutaways. The guys took some time last night to pack their parachutes very carefully. Right, next jumper coming in. He doesn't have a PWC. Right, the TA-300 parachute. Closer to the ground, the jumper will flare, pulling down on both tockles, decreasing forward speed and increasing lift. These guys are the best of the best. Excellent. Right, next jumper coming in. You can see the PWC on its feet. There's about 75 kilograms of equipment in that container, so he's extremely heavy when he jumps. Beautiful. Dropping the equipment and landing on it. Next. You can see he's wearing his white helmet. To the helmet will be fitted the oxygen mask for high altitude operations. Right, you can see that the juniors there and far down, they're also busy landing now. They formed a much better formation than during the rehearsals of yesterday, so training helps. The more you jump, the more confident you will become. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you can also now see further to the north is the Tandem Master. It is the larger 600-foot parachute, square canopy. We use the Tandem to infiltrate specialists that is non-para-qualified, like doctors and other specialists, artillery observers and so forth. The Tandem Master is Captain Pajana from the training facility in Bloemfontein. He's got several thousand jumps under the belt. He's both an HAPO instructor and a Tandem Master. Right, turning into the wind. Perfect. I say. Remember, this is not a civilian free fall. It's much more technical than that. These guys just make it look very easy. Right, Tandem Master's slightly overshooting, but he's now committed for the landing. Passenger picks up the legs. I say. I say, there's only one way to land with a Tandem, and that is on the backside. Right, ladies and gentlemen, that was a very good show from the members from the Pathfinder platoon from Bloemfontein, supported by members from the South African Defense Forces Parachute School in Bloemfontein. That concludes our events. They will now move off non-tactically. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Colonel Dixon, ladies and gentlemen, just one more thing to say about this is the technique with that Tandem is popularly used where we need a particular specialist that is required on the battlefield that might not be qualified to jump themselves. And that is why you see it may be sometimes a medical doctor that is required out there and can also be inserted vertically by means of a Tandem parachute. We move on, ladies and gentlemen, with the program. We are going to start off now that once these members have landed, they would have marked their desert, and they have, would have made sure that we have got our ears and our eyes on the ground further in the deep of the battle space. Gentlemen, the kinetic energy activities are now going to commence. We are going to start with a ground-aided interdiction in the deep, although we are going to be simulating it here in the close for you to be able to see. This will be conducted by members of the South African Special Forces. They are currently in their forming up place. They will be entering the area from your left, and their insertion on the ground will be covered from the right by their own direct fire support base. Ladies and gentlemen, the members are going to first start by cover fire, and it will be activated from your right-hand side to the south. And once the enemy's heads on the objective has been kept low, the members of our special forces will then be inserted. They will be coming in, rolling in from your left. In other words, from the north. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got all the capabilities that are integrated here. We always make sure that all our forces, as they get engaged, have got protection either from the ground or from the air. The members of the South African Special Forces will be supported by the Rooivalk Combat Support Helicopter. They will be coming, rolling in with them from the north. The covering fire will commence from the south on the high ground where they have got their direct fire support base established. They have started already. They have opened with their engagement, and you will see, ladies and gentlemen, that I'm going to let the firepower speak for itself. Observe, ladies and gentlemen, as they come rolling in from your left. ladies and gentlemen, these members fear nothing but God. They deploy in the deep, ladies and gentlemen. They do a deep interdiction. They can do raids in the deep. They cut off enemy communication lines, sustainment lines. Make sure that the opposing force does not have any cohesion anymore to can fight as a credible force against own forces. See, ladies and gentlemen, that they have now debussed in front. The firepower has now been increased as they create for themselves a corridor to plant their own bunker bomb in preparation for their quick withdrawal. This is typically what the raid of this nature will, how it will happen. They are still debussed. The necessary corridor that they require has been created. They will plant their bunker bomb in preparation then for the final withdrawal. All the time, ladies and gentlemen, they will have their combat support in the form of the Royfalk combat support helicopter, and they will also have their own weapons that are providing them with a covering fire from the flank. In this case, you can hear the amount of firepower that is being delivered from your right-hand side, in other words, from the southern flank. The force in front of you, ladies and gentlemen, might look small. However, if you measure them in terms of the firepower that they carry, you will realize that this is the firepower equivalent to a much bigger force than what you see in front of you. And that is where the speciality of our special forces come from. Will now embark, ladies and gentlemen, in preparation for their withdrawal. And once again, from their direct fire support base, they will increase the tempo of firepower in order to cover that withdrawal. ladies and gentlemen, the firepower speaks for itself to cover the withdrawal of these commandos from their objective. They would have also planted their own bunker bomb that will finally ensure that they are completely cut off from whatever eventuality that might follow them from the objective. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, these activities are done in order to ensure that the battle space has been shaped successfully in own forces' advantage, so that we can now begin to commit own forces into contact with opposing forces in an environment that is favorable to us. Ladies and gentlemen, the battle space have been shaped successfully by special forces and air force. Now, ladies and gentlemen, own forces continue to shape the battle space with indirect weapons, making sure that no influence can come also from the air, by means of firing the air defense weapons. This is in preparation for the commitment of own forces in contact with opposing forces here in front. The artillery strike from the south have taken place. You have observed as it came in. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the final act in making sure that neither from the air nor from the ground will there be any interference in the execution of own forces plan here in the close. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what these members have been training for the entire year. This is the integration of various elements of the South African Army, bringing in their firepower to bear to make sure that opposing forces can be defeated in a short space of time as possible. Now that the battle space has been shaped, ladies and gentlemen, the commander has made the decision to commit his covering troops in a safe environment where the battle space is to our advantage. The covering troops will enter the battle space from the north, in other words, your left as you are seated, and they will be led by elements of the mechanized modern brigade. The mechanized modern brigade is another of the new capabilities of the South African Army, where we have reinvigorated the army and make sure that it is grouped into fighting formations. The mechanized modern brigade elements that will be forming part of the covering troops will be led by the armored cars, the 76 millimeter Rooikot armored cars. These are the members of the 1 Special Services Battalion that is stationed out in Bloemfontein Center City. These members, ladies and gentlemen, will be closely followed by members of the mechanized infantry brigade, also from the same modern brigade, mechanized modern brigade, as you see the indirect weapons beginning to go into their secondary role of a fire support for the elements that will be engaged here in front. The commitment of the armored cars, the cavalry troops, ladies and gentlemen, has been tactically delayed by the commander due to the existence of the air threat in the area that is still persisting. To this end, our air defense artillery capability has been tasked with the work of ensuring that our skies are safe from any opposing force aircraft. The members that are currently doing this are members of 10 anti-aircraft regiment that is based out in Kimberley, and they have got on both the left and right hand side of the defensive area here in front of you deployed 23 millimeter guns on Bosfark as well as the 35 millimeter guns. The commitment of the covering troops, ladies and gentlemen, will also, similar to what you saw with Special Forces and all the other fighting elements, they will also be coming in under the cover of both the indirect weapons as well as escorted by the Rooivalk attack, I say again, the Rooivalk combat support helicopter. They are moving in a shortening distance from your left, in other words, from north to south. They will be closely followed then by mechanized infantry elements from 8 South African Infantry Battalion based out in Upington, Northern Cape. These elements, ladies and gentlemen, are the mechanized elements that forms part of the new mechanized modern brigade of South Africa. Formerly, we used to refer them as a 4-3 South African Brigade. During exercise Vukuhlome, a 4-3 Brigade, or the Mechanized Brigade, was regrouped into a task group, and their name was changed then to a task group Ingwe. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, the covering troops currently entering the fray in front of you are then the covering troops, the leading detachments of Task Group Ingwe, which is the mechanized modern brigade. This brigade is under the command of Brigadier General Manciani. And they will now be executing, ladies and gentlemen, their mobile defense, which they will start from the covering troops in front, handing over the fire to the maneuvering force, maneuvering the opposing force into the predetermined killing zone before handing over that battle to the fixing force here in front that will be led by members of the motorized modern brigade. I say again, Brigadier General Siqina, and with elements in the defense led by Lieutenant Colonel de Kock, the officer commanding 14th South African Infantry Battalion. All the indirect fire support bases are active, making sure that the insertion of the covering troops is covered from any potential interference from opposing forces, and that indeed the situation in front, the tactical situation in front, is to their favor. Armored cars, ladies and gentlemen, are commanded by Major Brendan Bosman. As you see them entering the area in front of you, this, ladies and gentlemen, is the armored cars. These are reconnaissance elements of the South African Armor Formation. They are capable of conducting wide reconnaissance as deep as possible. They are armed with a 76 millimeter quick firing gun themselves. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, they are capable of making a stand with the enemy themselves, although we do not like to commit them in decisive battles. Indirect fire capabilities continue. These are members from 4 Artillery Regiment based out in Potchefstroom. They have got deployed to the south, 120 millimeter M5 mortars, 155 millimeter G5s, 155 millimeter G6s, as well as the 127 millimeter multiple rocket launcher system that you saw deliver the first artillery strike earlier. These members of 4 Artillery Regiment are now in their secondary role. They will continue to provide fire support to the commitment of direct forces here in front, making sure that they can deploy safely. Of one Special Services Battalion enters the fray. These are the covering troops. They are closely followed by mechanized elements from from 8 South African Infantry Battalion in Upington. These members, ladies and gentlemen, are now ready to conduct this wide reconnaissance where they will seek the opposing force. Their orders are to make contact as soon as the opposing force have been located, to make contact with the opposing force by fire, and then start maneuvering them into a predetermined killing zone that has been established here in front. Take note, ladies and gentlemen, that once again, as I explained, these are members of the Mechanized Modern Brigade, and they are under the command of Brigadier General Mangiani. Ladies and gentlemen, the armored cars has already made contact by fire with the opposing force. They have reported this effect to the commander. The commander has ordered them to fire back. Ladies and gentlemen, the covering troops have made a contact. Their primary role now is to ensure that contact is maintained with the enemy so that indeed they could be handed over to the maneuvering force, because in the end, the commander wants the maneuvering force to be maneuvered, to maneuver the opposing force to his predetermined killing ground. Mechanized infantry from South African, I say again, from 8 South African infantry are the ones that are now moving in behind the front lines of the covering troops. They have been ordered to half integrate with the armored cars already, with the view of ensuring that a balanced maneuvering force can then start the process of maneuvering this opposing force to the killing zone. The Roycott armored car, ladies and gentlemen, is extremely quick. It is extremely versatile, and it is armed with a 76 millimeter quick firing gun that gives it the capability to be able to do a independent limited fight by itself. It is not intended to engage with tanks because it is not a tank. However, it is capable of making contact for own forces out in front and ensuring that that contact is maintained for us to be able to maneuver this force to where we want them to be. In this case, ladies and gentlemen, you will see that half integration has already been achieved between the armored cars and elements of 8 South African Infantry Battalion. 8SAI is firing already with their secondary weapons to make sure that the fire tempo can be increased to allow the withdrawal of the armored cars so that we can then redeploy them as a flank force. Observe, ladies and gentlemen, from the south, in other words, your right-hand side coming in, will be the Royfalk combat support helicopter that is aimed at also providing support both with rockets as well as their onboard 20 millimeter gun to the forces committed in battle in front. This action is aimed, ladies and gentlemen, as ensuring that the fire tempo can be increased to cover the withdrawal of the armored cars. As you see now, the smoke indicating the front line of own troops to give an indication to the Royfalk as to where that front line of own troops or flot is. Observe, ladies and gentlemen, as the Roycott withdraws from this area. In the dip, you will see that the indirect fire support base continue to provide indirect fire support to make sure that indeed the military mission given to us here in front can be achieved decisively and quickly. Utility of the armored cars, ladies and gentlemen, allows it to counter and cover vast terrain as quick as possible, while at the same time with the quick firing gun that it has, it allows it also to cover as much as possible of opposing force fighting capabilities as possible to defeat them and to destroy them. ladies and gentlemen, also observe the smooth integration of the Roy Falk combat support helicopter with the ground forces that it supports. This is the combat support that you get from the air, added to the combat support that we are giving to these forces from the indirect fire capabilities deployed further on to the south. The maneuvering force here in front, ladies and gentlemen, is experiencing a high resistance. They have reported this to the commander, who has ordered them to fight on stop lines, fighting back towards their predetermined killing zone. They are taking their stop bounce to the rear, making sure that as they do, they maintain contact with fire with their opposing force. Ladies and gentlemen, the maneuvering battle is coming down. The fight will shortly be handed over to the fixing force that is in the defensive locality that is deployed here in front of you. Gentlemen, as you see the covering fire continuing, making sure that the fixing actions are beginning here in front. Members of 8th South African Infantry Battalion withdrawing to the north. This maneuvering battle now, ladies and gentlemen, is being handed over to the fixing force. The fire tempo is gonna be increased from the indirect weapons, making sure that the enemy is forced into deploying and taking firing positions so that then the fixing actions can be activated by own forces. The Roy Falk combat support helicopter, ladies and gentlemen, has now moved over to join the defensive line
and they will now be providing missile fire for the elements of the fixing force here in front. The fixing force, ladies and gentlemen, is mostly members of the, all of them is the members of the motorized modern brigade under the command of Brigadier General Sikrina, and the commander of the fixing force here in front is Lieutenant Colonel De Kock, the officer commanding of 14th South African Infantry Battalion from Umtata. Once the last of the vehicles of HSI have left the area, Broken Arrow has been reported by means of a flare, and this symbolizes the start then, ladies and gentlemen, of the defensive fire plan as you see it unfolding. Please observe the defensive fire plan. Ladies and gentlemen, in line with this defensive fire plan, the South African Army is introducing some of its new weapon systems that it have acquired in the meantime for the anti-tank capability deployed directly in front of you to the north is the Carl Gustav anti-tank weapons. They will be utilized together with the AT-4 also in the anti-tank role. These two weapons, ladies and gentlemen, forms part of the quick reaction force capabilities within our South African infantry, and you can watch the devastating effect that they have when employed in the anti-tank role, ladies and gentlemen, and they will be employed on various distances from 300 meters as the first anti-tank target. You see it going out up in smoke. They will be also being employed on long range up to 2 kilometers in front of you. The black smoke that you see, ladies and gentlemen, is also from the Carl Gustav airbursts that you see them where they are fired utilizing the airburst to spread over the shrapnel on a much bigger killing zone. The defensive fire plan continues, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, the purpose of this is to ensure that the enemy that has been maneuvered successfully here in front is now finally fixed to bring about a planned final decision point for the commander to employ his focus of main effort. Own inherent mortars, ladies and gentlemen, are supporting this defensive battle deployed at both to your left and to your right. 81 millimeter capabilities from both 1 South African Infantry Battalion in Bloemfontein and then also from 8 South African Infantry Battalion in Upington. These are the capabilities that are providing this fixing force with indirect firepower.
Ladies and gentlemen, observe in front of you in the open, next to the air defense gun, the Carl Gustav weapon being fired. Look at the accuracy, ladies and gentlemen, of it in its anti-tank mode, both at short as well as middle range. It is fired, ladies and gentlemen, together with the AT-4, both of them in their anti-tank role. There, ladies and gentlemen, you see how one of the opposing forces' armored vehicles goes up in smoke. The impact of the Carl Gustav. The Carl Gustav, ladies and gentlemen, have successfully destroyed their target here in front. Ladies and gentlemen, the commander is now carefully assessing the fixing action here in front, because this marks the decision, the final decision point for him to expose his focus of main effort. All the reports that are flowing back to command indicates that the force here in front have been successfully fixed, and that they are unable to manifest their intentions as a cohesive unit. And for that reason, ladies and gentlemen, that the commander is satisfied that he can now unleash his focus of main effort to finally destroy the opposing force here in front. Ladies and gentlemen, the commander has ordered Vukuhlome. The commander has ordered Vukuhlome. He is now unleashing his trump card from the north and from the south, ladies and gentlemen, to approach the fixed opposing force in the predetermined killing zone. Will be a force under the command of Lieutenant Colonel Majila, from the commander of 1 South African Infantry Battalion. These are also members of the Mechanized Modern Brigade, forming part of the focus of main effort, led by the members of 1 South African Tank Regiment down in Bloemfontein. Half integrated already behind them, ladies and gentlemen, members of 1 South African Infantry Battalion, also in Bloemfontein. From left and from the right, they will converge in the center and conduct the final destruction of the fixed opposing force elements here in front. Observe, ladies and gentlemen, as they are led by the tanks, their barrels already facing the front, firing already on the move from the right and from the left, secondary as well as main weapons, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, observe the shock effect that only a tank can bring to any battlefield. Firing on the move. They have got their guns that are stabilized to allow them to do so. Ladies and gentlemen, the members of one South African tank regiment in front, behind them mechanized infantry members from one South African infantry battalion. This force is commanded by the commander of one South African infantry battalion, and this is the final destruction battle. Has already ordered that mechanized infantry must half integrate with the tanks in order to ensure that maximum firepower can be brought to bear to, as quickly as possible, achieve the destruction effect. Ladies and gentlemen, a full integration has now been achieved between the tanks and mechanized infantry. The fire tempo has been increased. The main weapons of the infantry have now also been activated. the indirect firepower capabilities, both inherent mortars from the infantry, as well as from the south, the artillery with long-range guns have been activated to ensure that the final destruction is indeed achieved as quickly as possible. Ladies and gentlemen, the final destruction battle continues. It is the 1 South African Tank Regiment, members of the Mechanized Modern Brigade in front, supported by infantry 81mm mortars on both flanks, supported by 155mm artillery G5 as well as G6. And these members are now keeping the firepower to bear, making sure that the enemy, as ordered, can be finally destroyed here in front. The commander has now ordered the quick exploitation on the objective by the elements committed here in front, which will start shortly. They are now just reporting ready to him to conduct that final action. Request to all the uniformed members that are sitting up here as spectators to please, when we are done here, to move and form up in the area there where the ambulances are. There are sergeant majors there that will indicate to you where to go. Please ensure that nobody moves back to the rear. Ladies and gentlemen, the activities here are still not completed. We request all of you to please sit down. all members to sit down. The commander has now ordered a fire for effect with his indirect capabilities. And I noticed that he ordered the rate also to be increased to rate intense. Have now gone into a fire belt action that you can clearly hear from where you are sitting, ladies and gentlemen. The firing tempo is now being taken up significantly to ensure that the closing stage of this military action is indeed successful for the destruction of opposing forces here in front. Ordered all his direct weapons to increase their tempo at a rate intense in order to ensure that the withdrawal of his focus of main effort from the front is not interfered with. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, the focus of main effort is withdrawing under the cover of a fire by the indirect fire. And as they withdraw, the reports that are beginning to filter in now, ladies and gentlemen, is a force that has been reported grouping to the north and northeast. We are currently waiting confirmation from our intelligence sources to determine what is the size and intentions of that force. It is suspected at this stage that it could be a link-up or a force that is a reinforcement type. The commander has got a number of contingencies once that has been confirmed to deal with that decisively. In the meantime, the focus of main effort has achieved the mission here in front. The opposing force elements that were fixed in the predetermined killing zone have been successfully destroyed, and with the exception of this possible reinforcement that has been reported, we can already say that the mission is achieved. Ladies and gentlemen, just a quick announcement while the activities here in front unfold. All the guests that are seated in both marquee tents to please remain seated, and all the military spectators that are seated on the hills left and right of the main grandstand to please form up in the area to the north, there where military police vehicles are standing. The members that are in the two marquee tents to remain standing, are seated, and when we move this, the people will then move there. I correct myself, that is the action that must take place after the last activity that we are doing here. Please, we are still going to finalize the tactical activity thereafter the message that I gave through to you, please, to take place.
Zero Golf 9, 400 on the ground.
Ladies and gentlemen, particularly the military colleagues, as you were is a command. As you were, it is a command. Ladies and gentlemen, the focus of main effort have now reported all weapons empty and safe. They have now been ordered to withdraw. They will be shortening distance towards the northern direction as you see them starting to move. Our battlefield surveillance sources have confirmed, ladies and gentlemen, there is indeed a force. This is a link-up force that is coming in from the north and northeast. They are coming down towards the area, our area of interest, with high speed. The commander has called up his indirect as well as the air defense to prepare a strike that will take place as soon as
the opposing force is at a tactically correct space. It is confirmed, ladies and gentlemen, that they are coming in, supported also by ground elements as well as air. It is for that reason that the commander has put both his air defense artillery capabilities on standby, as well as his indirect firepower in the form of the artillery. This artillery strike, as well as the air defense, will be done, ladies and gentlemen, by means of the 127mm multiple rocket launcher system, as well as all the 23 as well as the 35mm air defense artillery guns deployed in the defense in front of you. Ladies and gentlemen, you can then observe the focus of main effort withdrawing. These are the members of one South African infantry battalion, and they also have got with them the members of one South African tank regiment. The idea, ladies and gentlemen, of a modern brigade, I hope by now you have seen it in reality unfolding in front of you. We started with the light modern brigade, then we moved over to the mechanized brigade as well as the modern brigade. In between, we also showed you the elements of the airborne brigade, and you will see that among all of them are various members of the reserve brigade, which also formed part of exercise of Vukuhlome. All in all, ladies and gentlemen, all the five brigades were executing the activities that you saw here in front of you, supported by Special Forces, South African Air Force, South African Military Health Services, as well as members from the Military Police Division. For safety reasons, ladies and gentlemen, the commander has given a stop to the strike that is planned on the incoming opposing force. Once the last of the focus of main effort elements has cleared the area, then the commander will continue then with the final strike. Ladies and gentlemen, the following announcement. The following announcements, ladies and gentlemen, the guests that are seated inside the marquee tent to please remain seated. All the other military spectators to please form up in the fire break directly in front of the marquee tent. Please leave your chair behind. Leave your chair behind. You're going to form up in a military squad. Leave your chair behind and form up in front of the marquee tent on the fire break. Thank you. Gentlemen, as the focus of main effort withdraws, the confirmation has been received of the impending threat has been ladies and gentlemen, I say again, the impending threat has been confirmed. The opposing force movement is determined in coming down in a southern direction from the hills in front of you to the north northeast. The strike has been prepared to decisively bring an end to the activities of this opposing force elements, and to that effect both the air defense as well as field artillery elements have reported already.
Hi, gentlemen, ladies, let's move, let's move. The people on the left-hand side there, just come a little bit quicker to the center. Quick, quick. When you are in the squad and you are formed up, just stand still. Those people on my right-hand side, start moving. Listen, those people on the mountain, on the kopje on the right-hand side, come down. You are not demonstrating Marikana. Come down. Right, move, move. Just there, just there, just there, just there. Right, stay still. The front line, stay still.
Right, I've got one person on his way. Right. He will report shortly.
Okay, positive, because those guys. Right, come move, guys. Move, move. Okay, right, come another three.
Ladies and gentlemen, for safety purposes, we observed the moving out of the focus of main effort from the impact area. The opposing force elements that were coming in for reinforcement, they waited for us to start the demobilization and they moved in. We are now ready. The commander has ordered the final strike on this, and this, ladies and gentlemen, is the final argument of Kings. From the south, ladies and gentlemen, and from directly in front of you, ensuring that the airspace is clear of any opposing force element, and ensuring that the approaching force is finally and decisively dealt with, an artillery strike and air defense strike have been ordered. First, ladies and gentlemen, ensuring that the air is clear of any interference, and then bringing in from the south the final argument of Kings.
Test 1, 2, 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, that brings to a close the program for the final culmination of the South African Army training calendar for the year 2022. I now hand over to Zaza and Sunshine. Zaza?
Members on the left-hand side, just come this side. You must not hide. Just come this side. There's enough space here behind the people. Remember, we are forming up in mass. So come, those people there behind. Just come behind the forces here.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2022 has been a true cream of the crop. A first of this magnitude in the South African Army. Based on the Army's HR 45 strategy, our force design and force structure, the concept of the modern brigades leading up to this divisional exercise, which remarkably contains not just one, two, or three, but five brigades, being the mechanized brigade, the motorized brigade, the light modern brigade, which was designed to specialize in capabilities that deal with unrest situations and crowd control, the airborne modern brigade, and the reserve modern brigade, testing our combat readiness in order to be able to contend, to operate in the African battle space and respond to all threats in all forms. Avuka mabuthi Afrika.
Right. The people on my left-hand side, move back. There's vehicles that must come there where you are now. Right. Work on my command. Division. Attention. What elbow in the mouth? Right. This. Right. Move. 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 Those people in the back, move! Make sure you see the second member's son. Make sure you see the second member's son. Not with your mouth, with your movements. Right, the RSM down there, just make sure that they are in a straight line. Just make sure that they are in a straight line. Make sure you see the second member's face. Right, come now, come now. We're a division. That means we can act like one. We can operate like one. By the way, you're looking good. You're looking good. I'm not so sure about the smell, but you're looking good. Those members behind, we are waiting because of you. We don't wait for you. We are waiting because of you. Remember, you are still on attention. You are still on attention. There's a reason you got two ears and one mouth. Right, RSM, just thumbs me up if your section is ready. There's some other troops running there. Right here in front, just make sure you are standing right behind a member in front of you. Make sure you are standing right behind the member in front of you. Don't make your own squads. Sergeant Major Ndaba. Right, RSMs, I see you have got relatively control now. There's two POWs also coming. Right, RSMs. If they're in position, just give me a thumbs up. Just give me a thumbs up.
This line, go down, I can see it.
That's it. Just the end of the also, a little bit backwards. More. Right, just move, don't talk. Leave the talking to me. Fox vehicles, please just start moving. Keep moving. Right, the drivers here in the Hornets, please just pick up speed. Pick up speed. Pick up speed. Pick up speed.
Keep on facing that direction. But go there where to stop.
Right, can we keep up, pick up speed here, please? Right, Special Forces, you are driving too slow. You are driving too slow.
Guys, get yourself in a position there, man. They must drive all the way up until this, man.
Yeah, they're by Makhujani. I said Makhujani. Right. Makhujani, Sergeant Major Makhujani, let them stop right in front of you, more or less, so that they can be in view. Sergeant Major Makhujani, just go a few steps back, about 5 steps, 5-10 steps, go back, more, so that the entire force can fit in. More, Makhujani, more, just go more back. Right, move. The vehicles there in front, don't stop until I tell you to stop. Move. Right, the Sierra Fox vehicles, you are at the wrong place. Just pull off another 100 meters. Right, the Mambas also move forward. That's it. The Mambas also move forward so that the rest of the force can come in. Right, all the rattles, go down at the back next to the, behind the other Caspers and the Mambas. Right, that rattles and Caspers on the left hand side, just pick up a little bit of speed. Right, that Caspers, pick up speed. The Caspers. Right, move, move the members, move a little bit forward, more, more. Right, the Juliet vehicles must also come on the other side of where the forces is standing. The Juliet vehicle. The Mfezis must also come on the other side. Yeah, you on the other side. Right, that mamba stop. The first mamba stop. First mamba stop. 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 The rest close up. Close up. Close up. The rest close up. Sussex close up a little bit. That's it. Close up, close up. Sasik, close up. Sasik, close up. Behind the mambas. Right, that horses of Sasik, the horses of Sasik, just go and line up there next to Sierra Fox. The horses of Sasik, that gecko move, that gecko move. Right, I said, just close up, not further than that. Just close up now. The MPs, just close up. right, the Juliet vehicle. The Juliet vehicle must be the last one. Respective commanders, tell your crew to stop. I say again, all vehicles stop, you are in. All vehicles stop. The last one is Mfezi. The brigade commanders are busy moving in. So stop!
Ladies and gentlemen, the flag ceremony will now commence, where the Chief of the South African Army, Lieutenant General Lawrence Kulekani Mbata, will hand over the SA Army flag to the Minister of Defence and Military Veterans, Honorable Thandi Modise. Thereafter, the Minister of Defence and Military Veterans will deliver her address. Thank you.
let me start off by acknowledging the Minister of Defense and Military Veterans, Meta Ndimudise, and the Deputy of Minister of Military and Military Veterans, Ndate Magwetla. Allow me to acknowledge all my counterparts from the continent, the entire general staff that is here, all the flag officers and admirals. Allow me, Honorable Minister, as I'm handing over this certificate to the Chief of Staff of the South African National Defense Force, representing the Chief of the South African National Defense Force, General Ruzwane Maphanya, whereby I am here to declare on behalf of the Pride of Lions, the South African Army, and allow me, Chief of Staff, to read, to say, I, 9465-4423, Papa Eko, Lieutenant General L.K. Mbata, Chief of the South African Army, hereby hand over a combat-ready landward force for employment to Chief of the South African National Defense Force, General Ruzwane Maphanya, our state of combat readiness. I'm saying this with honor and pride. Chief of Staff.
Deputy Minister of Defense, the Chief of Staff on behalf of the Chief of SANDF. Our distinguished guests from our neighboring states, from near and afar, chiefs of the service arms, men and women in uniform. It is an honor today to see so many of you gathered here. Son, standing for what you took an oath for, to diligently serve the Republic of South Africa, to protect its sovereignty and integrity, to protect life and soul, but importantly, to be able to own the label called South Africa, as South Africans. So while some of us take it for granted that South Africa is for all who live in it, some people had to die before all South Africans who could really see and feel that they live in it. We protect the Constitution of South Africa. We protect the people of South Africa because we, the first line of the people as the defense force, protect the rights of all South Africans here first. And all of those who live within our borders with us. So we shall always put South Africa first. But to put South Africa first, we must remember the soldier, the one who is almost always forgotten, the one who is the first to run to the battlefield when we get a threat, the one who does not eat at the high table, the one without whose hands and feet and heart this country means nothing. So we salute you, men and women of the South African National Defense Force. We thank you. You came out in numbers. I'm told there are 13,000 of us today gathered here for this exercise. While it might be seen as an exercise, it must also be what I am told it is by the Chief of the Army. Our preparedness, our readiness, to protect this country. Bangathi azange sicho ukuthi sikhona. Bangathi we did not say we will always stand ready to defend what is ours. Bangathi, amongst that which is important for South Africans in this country, is the dignity of the man, woman, and child of this country. And therefore, as we salute you in uniform, we must also agree that we have a duty to take care of you and better care of you. That we intend to rejuvenate and to see to it that those little things that prohibit and inhibit our progress to really shine as the military of South Africa are taken out of your way. That your equipment is in pristine position. that you behave because we have removed those things that lead up to ill discipline within the Defence Force. But that in that protection of the dignity and the safety of South Africa, we ourselves in uniform are disciplined, are protective of one another and protective of what is ours, living and property. I want to thank you for standing in the sun. When I was younger, they told us there is no rain and there is no sun in the army. If you can withstand this heat in this particular geographic spot, and I was born not far from here, so I know the heat. You can withstand the heat even at equator. You can withstand the deprivation. You can withstand the humiliation. You can withstand sometimes the poor Russians that get your way when we have the wherewithal to make sure that you sleep well, you eat well, you are uniformed, you are made to travel well. Those things will be attended to. This operation, this exercise, ithi masivuke sihlome. Xa uvuka uhlome, uthi asibasabi. Uthi we are ready. Uthi I, the individual citizen of South Africa, stand to become counted when the time comes. Throwing that back to you, individual soldier, be punctual, be honest, do all the things that we expect from the defense. Do all those things that protect your dignity and our dignity as a country. I am told I must not keep you in the sun. I do not know of the army that faints in the sun. I can talk about other arms of services. But I do take heed that it is hot, and I thank you for your service and for your continued service to this country. We deploy you all over. We risk everything to ensure that not only South Africa, but SADC is secure. We do not cut corners when we take an oath and when we deploy. In your deployments, serve diligently, serve faithfully, serve honestly.
Top or what to close?
The team.
What's going on then?
You will remember that South Africa faces many challenges. Unemployment has risen in this country. Poverty levels are high. When unemployment rises, it brings its own issues. You will also remember that we speak with the scars of August 2021 still fresh. You will also remember that a threat in the region cannot be a threat that we ignore as a South African National Defense Force. Because when you look at what is happening in the region and you look at the movement that is intensifying into the South African territory, you will realize that there is nothing but sometimes people thinking they will get better economic opportunities in this country. That brings a tension sometimes. If your economy has not been doing well, if the food prices go high, if your power is not stable and guaranteed, obviously the first people who are going to get restive are your own citizens. So we must take all these matters into cognizance when we deal with what we face as a defense force. Our job is not to go into the streets. We only go there when we are requested to do so in support of the police. It does not mean that the South African National Defense Force cannot prepare to be ready for any eventuality. It does not mean that we will stand by and see South Africa caving in while we are waiting for people to deploy, because in fact, the Defense Act empowers, as much as it empowers the President, it does also give the Minister of Defense the authority to deploy when the need arises. And we take that very seriously, that we do not want to unleash members of the Defense Force amongst the civilians. At least we want to continue respecting that their training is such that you cannot unleash them unprepared or not under a civilian authority when they are unleashed amongst the civilians. So for us, those are the things we are looking at. Can we do something as the Defense Force to ensure that threats on the surety and availability and protection of our power supplies is done? Yes, we can. We have been asked to look at whether we can start looking at taking care of the electrical and power installations throughout, because yes, there are failures of ESCOM, but also yes, there are instances where clear sabotage is there. We have also been called upon to look at another threat to the growth of our economy, which presents a serious threat to this country: the dismantling of our shore railway systems. And yes, we are considering, we are ready to deploy to protect that, because any economy that cannot guarantee shore transportation of its goods does not do well in ensuring that its economy grows. So we are always ready. But we will not interfere with the police. They must do their job. Our facilities have been availed to them for training. We hope that the training that the new ones are getting will enable them to deal with civil matters without us being called in. But until then, we will be on standby to protect every life and property in South Africa. Thank you.
Final question. Seeing the demonstration here today, are you confident that the South African National Defence Force is able to protect the country? Are you happy with the capabilities you've seen here today?
I am confident that we are doing everything within our powers to make sure that the prime equipment is restored, is upgraded. I am confident that we are looking at the reinvigoration of our defense industry to ensure that new technologies come into play. I am sure that we are looking at our universities and we are talking about what else we need to do to ensure that we don't just rely on exports and things outside, but at things that we can do for ourselves as a country. Every trip I have taken so far as a Minister of Defense has also been about meeting and looking at what those who have agreements with us have, what they can exploit for us, but what we can exploit for our own good. So I am sure that those who think, especially the army, is down and out, are wrong. Give us time, not too long. We will have ensured that every cent that we do not want to return to the treasury is plowed back at ensuring that these men and women who are now standing in the sun are properly equipped, fed, and housed to make sure that we protect to the best of our ability. So, yes, I have every bit of confidence in the National Defense Force to protect the South African community and its economy. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Let's allow the minister.
Can we withdraw?
Yeah.
Can I tell the members to rise?
Yes.
Can all members to rise when the minister is withdrawing, please?
Chief. Interview the chief.
Parade, parade, attention!
Can we allow the minister just to withdraw?
Come
Parade! Stand! Arise!
You may be seated, please. We are not finished. Just give us a second. You may be seated.
to answer the easy questions and then I will leave the difficult ones for him.
Good day, sir. I'm Precious from Gurara FM. Two mics. Don't worry, I have two mics. Don't worry. The one is from the radio and the one is for here so the audience can hear. Last week we had a career expo and it was very informative. We as the local media, we were quite impressed of what actually took place here. For our young people in the district, how beneficial was the Career Expo and what happened today for our young people in the district, especially the young learners who are still upcoming and want to be inspired to become soldiers in the district and also in the province?
In fact, to respond to the question, the Defense Force, the Armed Forces belongs to the people of this country. And for this Defense Force to be able to honor its constitutional mandate, it is important that the people of this country should take ownership on that Defense Force. Now, when we talk about the future of this Defense Force, you cannot actually even talk about it without considering the young people of this country, the people who will take it into the future as a force for good, as a force for the people of this country, as the force to serve with honor and dignity. And I can tell you that expo that was held was first and foremost to demonstrate the skills, the opportunities that are there within the South African National Defense Force, and in particularly the South African Army, where we are saying to these young people, you have every right, you have every ability to ensure that you join the patriots that you see today standing in front of you and those standing in front of them. Because we believe to create a better society, to create a stable and secure society, it is a calling to each and every South African. And for us to respond to that calling, we were saying with the expo to those young people, the opportunity and the sky is the limit for them. So there are great opportunities for them. They are expected to play a meaningful contribution in ensuring that, from the words of the minister, that we remain a force for good.
Do you think that opportunities are being made more aware to our communities in the Army or Defense Force?
The word that I can say to you, especially from the last expo, we are growing by the day. We are working to the best of our ability. From the response that came out, we are encouraged actually to ensure that we cover each and every corner of our society. The demand from those who are part of that expo was a clear message to the South African Army and the entire South African National Defense Force to say, we want to see more of these opportunities. We want to see more of the force that ensures that we are stable and secured. We want to see more of a force that says it is a force for the people of this country, with the great opportunities that are made available to them to say, it is for all of us, and they are allowed also, and they must feel free to join, and as young people, with a clear mission to keep on rejuvenating what is there. Remember, for those that are here today, there were those that were there before, and those that are here today are no more young. So we need those young people to ensure that we create and sustain and protect our beautiful South Africa for generations to come.
Do you think our young people are more demoralized in terms of job opportunities, of getting job opportunities in the Defense Force or the Army to actually be indulging in drugs and alcohol?
I won't respond to the word that demoralized. Rather, I would say we are fully aware of their desire to join the ranks and swell the ranks of the South African Army. We acknowledge those realities within broader society, that those realities are there of our young people due to unemployment. but we understand also the state of our economy, and we understand so far from the side of the armed forces with the limitations and constraints that we have. We are looking forward, and we know with the little that we have, the best in terms of ensuring that we absorb these young people to come on board. We are doing our utmost best in ensuring that.
As a media house in the district and also in the province, we would like you to give a message of support, of encouragement to our youngsters, actually in who wants to join the Defence Force. Close down in this interview. Thank you.
Our founding fathers and our founding mothers of our beautiful democratic RSA have laid a very firm foundation. It is the obligation and responsibility of each and every South African, and in particularly the young people, to understand and accept that role in a clear, determined way, that their determination and will to make their difference where it matters most should be their strongest weapon, rather than thinking that they have no role to play in our society. So we encourage them, just like those who were there before us, they as a generation, there is also an expectation. And we believe it is when we work together as a South Africa, including our young people, we will be able to take this great and beautiful nation to higher heights and make South Africa to be a country for a better life of all those that are living in it. Thank you. Thank you.
Afternoon, General. I see that you got a nice new uniform on. That looks pretty good. I'd just like to know, what is the schedule for the rollout of the new uniform across the SANDF? Why is there a new uniform? And are there any other improvements and upgrades coming to the SANDF? Thanks.
Just to be precise to the question that you have raised, what you are actually witnessing today is the commencement of that rollout. But that rollout is going to be conducted and executed in phases, based on the fact that the research institute known as CSIR and our partners involved in ensuring that the beautiful uniform that I'm wearing today, reflecting, which is part of the pride, will be enrolled over a period of time. The difference of this uniform, I can assure you, a lot of study, a lot of research by our scientists have looked into it. The pattern of this uniform and what you see, it's living up to its name, to ensure that our forces, when they're exposed to theater, they are camouflaged in the true sense of its meaning. It is a uniform that when you look at it in terms of its durability and be able to survive or to be sustained within all weathers within our region and the continent, we believe that the research that has been done, it is value for money. And we are looking forward to expedite the process in ensuring that those forces that are deployed both internally and externally are equipped to the fullest within a short possible space of time, so that wherever they are, and in the words of the minister, to ensure that our soldiers are equipped and are ready for battle based on the assignment that they are given.
Thank you very much, General Mbatha. We truly appreciate your wisdom in terms of responding to all the questions. Thank you very much, sir. Can I now request all the dignitaries to go to our static display? We are finished with the program of the day. Now I'll hand over to the ceremony. Thank you very much for your attendance.
The rest of the troops, the RSM takes over. Together with the mechanized, you can march off.